Hey everybody, it's Andy. In Figuring This Out today, we're going to take a look at how to make goals the right way and also the one big, huge roadblock that people don't know about that caused them to not be successful at their goals. So let's get started. So if you're watching this video, it's probably safe to say that you have some goals. In fact, human beings are kind of unique in that way. We're the only species that sets goals for ourselves. We have this need to improve, to get just a little bit better, to do something new, or to become someone different. In fact, we've been doing it since the dawn of time, but goals were much more simple back then. At the get-go, we just wanted to make sure that we could stay alive and not get eaten by the wild animals. And it's progressed since then. We have financial goals, we have goals to save up for vacations, we have goals to spend more time with the people that we love, we have goals to amass more Instagram followers, and the list goes on and on. Now, I know you're smart because you're watching this video, and I'm gonna get right to it. Here is the best method according to everything that I've looked at. It's the SMART method, credited back in 1981 to George Doran, who organized this acronym to help his company make decisions better. Solid goal is specific, it's measurable, it's achievable, it's relevant, and it's time-bound. We're gonna take a look at what that means in just a second here. But if you do these things, your goals are going to be very clear and easier to reach. We have tons of goals, okay? Goals to spend time with more family, goals to lose weight, goals to invest in the stock market or bankrupt a hedge fund. Wasn't that interesting this week? Goals to make more money, save more money, to work out. Maybe we have a goal to save up for that dream vacation somewhere in that all-inclusive resort to like Wuhan, China, or someplace like that. We have no shortage of goals in our lives. Here's a bad goal. It's not SMART. Get healthy. It's not specific. It's not measurable. It is achievable, but it's not time-bound either. This is the same goal, but a SMART goal. Lower my cholesterol by 50 before my physical next year, 12 months. We have all of the elements. It provides you with direction and clarity so you know exactly what you're shooting for, and when you get there, you know that you've hit that benchmark. The specific is lowering your cholesterol, that aspect of your health. It's measurable, 50. We can take a blood test and find that out. Before my physical next year, 12 months later. So it's achievable, 50 points is not that low for a cholesterol test, it's reachable, and it's time bound. So that is what you're looking for when you're making your own goals, to follow that SMART system. Through a couple of authors who have done heavy research on routines and habits and goal setting, it became quite apparent that if we don't have a routine or a habit in place to get us to that goal, the ability for us to get to that goal is not going to happen. Goals require willpower without routine and habits. And we know that willpower does not work. It's not consistent. It's not always there for us. When we're sleepy or we're stressed, those are the times where we're tempted to not chase our goals, not chase our dreams. So that's not going to work. James Clear, the author of Atomic Habits, says, "You do not rise to the level of your goals, you fall to the level of your systems." Huh? To be honest, that quote seemed a little bit lofty for me until I started to do more thinking about goals. It makes sense. If I set a goal to lower my cholesterol, and I just do the things like try to eat healthy when I can, and try to go to the gym and work out when I can, and do those things to lower the cholesterol, I'm not going to be very consistent, because a lot of days I just won't feel like doing that. But if I have routines and habits in place, losing those 50 points of cholesterol or saving that money in the bank for that dream vacation, maybe not Wuhan, China, let's pick a different place. Or maybe investing in the stock market is going to be a lot easier to do because I have those habits that get me there. So the idea is to Have a habit of working out daily. Have a habit of including vegetables daily. Those are things that we can do, and if they become part of our lifestyle, we will reach our goals. So the smart way to plan goals is perfect, but without habits and routine, it is not going to happen. And this is probably the biggest reason why people fail and they feel let down because they didn't reach their goal when it wasn't their fault. When you start planning your own goals for this year, they don't need to include every aspect of these every single time. But without habits in place and routines in place, the goals that we want to achieve will most likely not happen. All we need to do is to remember to add habits and routines to any goal that we set, and the chances of us achieving it are great. Think about what are those routines and habits that you can set in place so that you can reach these goals. And if you don't reach it in time, that's okay. It's about getting 1% better every day. And if we do that, we're definitely going to surpass our goals, even if we don't meet the time constraints that we put on ourselves. In conclusion, if you felt like this was somewhat valuable, please consider clicking the like button below this video, and also please consider subscribing. You click that red button down in the corner here. You can subscribe to the channel and even get updates when I release new videos every week. Awesome talking to you today. If you're going to plan some goals this year, I really hope you crush it in the goal system. I also have some videos right here about starting good habits and stopping bad habits, which relate directly to this video. So click on one of these to get more details on how to set those routines and habits for success this year. Hope you knock it out of the park, and we'll see you again next week. Take care, and thanks for watching.